First memory of riding was downtown Chicago at the carriage horse stable. I used to go there for lessons once a week.
And do you remember the first pony you ever rode?
First pony? Yeah, we had a pony called Samantha that came off one of those pony wheels, and it used to take off on the pony wheel. It was a dangerous pony, but it was a fun start.
Tell me about your international debut. What was it like?
I'm trying to think. I think it must have been in Wellington. I had a horse called Madison. It was a really great horse, sort of put me on the map for jumping bigger classes. And I think we were second in the Nations Cup, and I won the Grand Prix. And that was my first five-star Grand Prix win. So that was pretty special.
And what did it feel like to win your first Grand Prix?
I mean, that was, you know, I'd won a lot of Grand Prix, but that was the first sort of, you know, CSIO bigger Grand Prix. I guess I felt in that moment like maybe I can actually do this. I used to want to be a steeplechase jockey, so I used to race ponies, and I did pony club and things like that, and I hadn't done very many big shows. And then the trainer I was with in Chicago had me do a George Morris clinic, and after the clinic he said, you know, I really want to help your riding, and I think that you could really be good at this. And he invited me to come to Wellington, and he actually gave me 3 of his own horses to ride and set me up in his stable, and I started like that.
Wow, that's a tribute.
Yeah. I owe him a lot.
Because especially back then, George was, I mean, everyone talks about how he was harsh then. I mean, they think he's a little bit easier on everybody now. He was like hardcore.
Yeah, I don't know. I didn't know him way back in the day when he was in his real harsh days. But yeah, he was pretty tough.
Steeplechasing, huh? That explains actually.
Yeah. I gave up that dream. I heard it was really dangerous. So. I don't know. I don't know if I have a greatest career moment. I think I'm just more excited just to have a career. You know, this was kind of my way to get out of where I was and to do something that I love and, you know, be able to take care of my mom and stuff. So that was really cool for me. If I had to pick like a moment, I'd probably say doing that, you know, winning that first really big Grand Prix there, riding for the team. That was probably it, because then I felt like that I actually had a chance.
Who's your mentor?
Yeah, so many people have helped me in my career. I don't think it wouldn't even be fair for me to name somebody. So many industry professionals, you know, when I was a kid coming up, helped me in so many ways, gave me horses to ride, and, you know, continue to help me to this day, whether it's to get owners or, you know, other professionals, you know, giving me tips how to improve. You know, I'm a student of the sport. I try to learn from everybody. So I don't think there's one person that I'd name as a mentor. There's a long list of people that I'm very thankful helped me.
Is there one piece of advice that ever really stood out to you, that really impacted you at that moment in your career?
Best advice I ever got was probably from my father, who didn't know anything about horses, and that was to learn from everybody, copy nobody, and be the best version of yourself. I don't know. I like them all. I'd try to ride any of them, but I think you know, everybody would say Big Star is a special horse. I think Scott Brash's horse Ursula looks amazing. It's just really my type of horse. So maybe those two would be a good start.
Which fellow rider do you admire and why?
That's a long list. I admire anybody that does this at a high level. you know, that people dedicate their lives to doing this and to being good at it. And, you know, I have a lot of respect for so many different riders. If I wanted to model a career after somebody, you'd have to look at the people that have withstood the test of time, like a Ludger or Nick Skelton or Ian Miller, and these are guys that win on tons of horses, not just one superstar. And I think that really shows how talented they are. About Big Star?
Yeah.
I'd say that it's everything that you would want in a modern show jumper. I mean, he is the model of what we would all look for. You know, and he's fast, he's scopey, very adjustable, ultimate careful, great mind, wants to win. He's always with his rider. I've never seen him, you know, sort of let Nick down. And yeah, I think that's what we all want. I don't even know. I was so young, I just had a crazy idea that's what I was going to do. And I was determined that I was going to make it, and I never looked back. There wasn't really it wasn't a one particular thing.
You can say it was inevitable from day one then.
I don't know about that. I don't know if inevitable, but I was gonna give it my all anyway.
Do you think it's unique to do a sport? I mean, you compete at international level like so many athletes out there, but unlike any of the other ones, you have to work with horses. I mean,
yeah, I mean, I love working with animals and everything. That's great. There's so many things that I like about it. So when you ask me to name just one, that's hard. You know, I basically spend my time working with my friends and traveling around the world and working with horses and competing for a living. So, you know, I think all of those things are pretty amazing.
What does it feel like to represent the United States on the international stage for you?
I think it's always an honor to ride for your country. And to, you know, represent the U.S. around the world is a great feeling. You know, it's hard to get on our teams to start with because there's a lot of strong riders with good horses and good backers. So it already makes it difficult enough to even get there. And then when you are there, it's a great feeling to know that you probably have a pretty good chance to win something.
What characteristics are most valuable to being a successful international rider?
Resilience, I would say, is probably number one. You spend a lot of time losing. I mean, even the best people in the world, you have to figure that they probably actually win less than 20% of the time. So that means 80% or more you're losing or something goes wrong. So I think you have to be able to tolerate or withstand those down times and keep going. I think that's the most important thing.
If you could do anything else in the world, what would it be?
If I could do anything else in the world? I'd be a basketball player.
Yeah?
For sure. Everything I'm not. I could dunk and, you know, make crazy money doing that. That's what I'd do.